Wettkampf an dem Hobo Wettkampf 2014, where we have the ZTE Blade Q Maxi here in our hands, which is a 5-inch device with 5 megapixel and VGA front camera. We have the 2000 mAh battery inside here, which is removable, and also the single SIM card slot, 1 gig of RAM, and a quad-core 1.3 GHz processor. Dual-core 1.3 GHz processor from MediaTek, which you can actually read here, and actually all the specs you can just read for a second if you just pause the video. So let's check out the phone itself. We have a volume control rocker on this side, on the bottom microphone, mic USB on this side for charging, and on top you find a 3.5mm jack and the on and off switch right below the cable. On the back there is the camera with 5-megapixel autofocus, and also here is the flash and the microphone and a speaker right here on the bottom and logo. So as I said, you can take off the back cover, but you don't need to usually, only if you want to change the micro SD slot or the SIM card. So there's quite a few apps installed, as you can see on the front home screen, but if you go here inside the app drawer, you can see here even more. So let's just start the camera. You can see the front camera with the VGA 1 megapixel is alright, the speed is also alright, but of course, you will mainly use the back camera, I guess. Well, you can see that's also really fast. The display angle is also right for this cheap phone, and you can also see macro focus is also working quite nicely. So let's just go quickly into the browser to finish up our quick little hands-on of the ZTE Blade Q Maxi. Let's go into Chrome, where we have, of course, the keyboard popping up. You can see here we even have swipe, or you can just rotate the screen for having an even bigger keyboard if you want to type with two hands. So this was the ZTE Blade Q Maxi smartphone in a really short hands-on at the Mobile World Congress. Here a little size comparison with Apple iPhone 5S also, let's not miss that. Till next time, peace, and again, my name is Balazs, and again, don't forget to subscribe to Endeavor TV.